pregame.com. In my opinion, the best rivalry in the NFL in the last 15 years on NBC Sunday night. This is Brad Powers, pregame.com studios, just off the Vegas Strip. We're indeed talking Sunday night NFL action. We got a good one in the AFC North. We got the Baltimore Ravens at the Pittsburgh Steelers. And Fez, who do you like in this marquee matchup and why?
I'm on the favorite, the Men of Steel minus the five. It's all about Baltimore being overrated, in particular, that defense being overrated. Now, I can hear the complaints. Hey, Fez, they're the number one statistical defense in the NFL, and with good reason. They've gotten to face 5.5 backup quarterbacks, and that has completely skewed their stats towards looking like a complete dominating defense, when the truth is, yeah, they have a top five defense, but they don't have a defense that's historically good. Look at some of their wins. Oh, they shut out Matt Moore and the Miami Dolphins when Matt Moore could not play a lick, and they shut out and shut down the Oakland Raiders. They didn't shut them out, but they shut them down. Well, Manuel was quarterbacking for the Oakland Raiders in that game in Oakland. Games like that make a huge difference.
Let's talk about a couple of the other examples. They faced Green Bay, not with Aaron Rodgers behind center, but how about Hundley, a 23-0 win in that one. And then you look at them facing Houston with Deshaun Watson. No, not so much. Not with even the Macho Man, but the Nacho Man, Tom Savage. Another outlier performance that, you know, makes Baltimore's defense look better than expected.
Look, just last week, they jump up. They're up 20-0. Looks like they're cruising. Nope. Stafford brings Detroit all the way back. 27-20. The game is on the line, and then he gets knocked out of the game. Shocker. Then Baltimore pulls away against yet another horrible backup quarterback.
All right, both of these teams look like they're going to be in the playoffs, but I know that there's going to be a disparity in your power ratings that you post each and every week in the pregame forums.
Yeah, so I have the Steelers and right around fourth, fifth best team in the NFL. They're 5 points better than an average team. The Ravens, I have barely better than an average team, such that I make this game 4.5 on a neutral site, and the game's in Pittsburgh.
Ooh, some solid value in your power rankings. Your second key handicap.
Pittsburgh is in their best situation here. They're home. They're playing a rival. They're going to be motivated. Remember the book, when Pittsburgh plays at home, Big Ben is typically awesome, provided he is motivated. Doesn't matter if they play a good team. They played the Cincinnati Bengals, crush them. Played the Minnesota Vikings, crush them. Played the Titans, a perceived playoff team. Well, they will be a playoff team, but a perceived good team, crushed them. Where do they get in trouble? When they play an opponent they don't think that much of, that they're looking past. The Jacksonville Jaguars, yeah, early in the year, before anyone knew that the Jaguars were good. Well, they certainly are going to be up against the Ravens, and they certainly perceive the Ravens to be a playoff-caliber team. We're going to get Pittsburgh's best effort.
Now, you've had a tremendous NFL season, one of the best in the entire country so far this year, but I got my concerns on this pick, Fez. Couple of them. Number one, they're off a brutally physical game Monday Night Football against Cincinnati. Linebacker Shazier is out. Wide receiver Juju Smith-Schuster, he's suspended. Any concerns that with them coming off a physical game?
Major concerns, yeah. And I'm also concerned the fact that their most important game of the year is next week when they host the New England Patriots. The winner likely gets the number one seed. And because of that, this is a free play for me and not a play that I actually went ahead and invested dollars in my own bankroll.
And one more final concern for me. Doesn't this tend to be a relatively close series? The last 10, 15 years always seems to be decided by 3 points.
And always seems to trend towards the under. My numbers actually pointed to the over on the total, but I'm not going to ignore that series history where it seems like every game ends 20-17.
Makes sense. Let's go ahead and make it official.
Let's make it official. Baltimore is overrated. They've played against 5 backup quarterbacks this year, including Manuel for Oakland and Hundley for the Green Bay Packers. And Pittsburgh is in their best role at home versus a rival versus a perceived good team. They will be fully motivated. The Fez Mass says back the Steelers -5. More videos, pregame.com.